Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Today we had round 4 of Altibox Norway Chess 2018 and I will show you the victory of Karjakin against Maxim Vachelagrav, who played the Grandfield Defend. I must also give you a bad news. Yesterday morning, during the rest day, Dean Gliren went with his father for a little bicycle trip. And somehow he fell down and broke his hip, and he needs a surgery now. So today, of course, he couldn't play against Caruana, and he will probably abandon the tournament. So we wish him all the best luck for a fast and complete recovery. And so, after this bad news, we start with our commentary. So, as we said, this match is Karjakin against Maxim Vachelagrav. D4 for Karjakin, knight in f6, c4, g6, knight in c3 that wants to support the e4 push, and d5, the Grunfeld. Karjakin continue with the main line, that is the exchange variation, c capture in d5, knight capture in d5, e4, knight capture in c3, and b capture in c3. Bishop, of course, in fiancetto, in g7, bishop in c4 for Karjakin, c5, attacking for the third time the d4 pawn, and this is the pawn that will go under pressure in this opening, and white must be careful to defend it. Knight in c2 that develops the knight protecting the bishop, and as you can see, white avoids to develop the knight to f3 because of course it's a move that you can play, and if I'm not wrong, Kasparov himself like to play that move, knight in f3, but the knight in f3 will go under the pin after bishop in g4. So Karjakin prefers to avoid this pin and plays knight in e2. Knight in c6 for black, another attacker against the d4 pawn. Bishop in e3, castles for black and castles for white. b6 now for black, d capture in c5, queen in c7, and in the Grunfeld you will see the queen, especially in the opening phase, that she will often go to c7 because from there she attacks indirectly the bishop in c4 that is unprotected. Knight in d4 and knight in e5 for Vachelagrav. If we come back one move, we will see that capturing the knight in d4 is not a good idea because after c capture in d4, b capture in c5, rook in c1, and you can see that the same idea of watching from far black's queen, and of course black here can't capture in d4 because the queen after this discovery check is lost, after this check is lost by the rook discovery. So, coming back after rook in c1, black must avoid this type of line, playing e6. But after bishop in e2, white will recapture the pawn in c5, and is a bit better. So, coming back to when Karjakin played knight in d4, Vachelagrav doesn't want the knight to be changed. So he play knight in e5, white knight in b5 attacking the queen will retreat to b8. Now we must remember that white bishop in c4 is hanging because it's attacked by the knight in e5, so Karjakin retreats the bishop in e2, b capture c5, rook in b1, that attacks with X-ray the queen, but in this case there is not a good discovery. So a6 for Karjakin, knight in a3. This knight could also go to d4, because of course can't be captured, because black must move the queen, but also from there are not many good routes where to relocate this knight. So Karjakin choose to put knight in a3 to relocate it a bit later through the square c4. So queen in c7, of course, moving the queen, f4, starts to move something on the king side. Before moving the knight, blacks gain a tempo with the rook in d8, attacking the queen. The queen moves to c2, knight in g4, attacking the bishop. And now maybe here Karjakin could also play knight in c4, because he will lose the bishop pair, but maybe it was better not to let black also develop the white square bishop, but instead he capture with the bishop, and after bishop recapture in g4, after this move black equalize the position. So the position is equal, and black also has this this plus of the bishop pair. F5 for Karjakin, trying to undermine black structure in front of the king. G capture F5. The knight comes back into the game. Knight in C4. E6 by Maxim Vachelagrave. H3. Okay, pushing back the bishop to H5. E capture in F5. E capture in F5. And bishop in G5, attacking the rook. Now, this is one of the crucial points of this game, because Maxim Vachelagrave could move this rook, but he didn't. He chose to play F4, leaving the rook under fire. But let's see where he could put this rook. After rook in e8, knight in b6 attacking the other rook, rook in a7 because in b8 is not good, knight in d5 attacking the queen, queen in d7 remaining on the white squares, and c4, the game is still equal, playable for both colors. But at this point, after bishop in g5, Vachelagrave, maybe he thought that he could take the upper hand with this dynamic line, and he played f4, queen in f2. Here he would also be on time to move his rook to e8, but he kept attacking with f3. Now bishop captures in d8, rook captures in d8. Queen in h4 attacking the bishop, f capture in g2, and now white must save the rook because he is 2 pawns down, so the only advantage for white is that he has the rook pair. So Karjakin moves the rook to f1, from f to e1. The black bishop moves, because it was under attack, moves to f3. Rook in e3, attacking the bishop. Bishop retreat in c6. Rook in e1, doubling the rook. And rook in f8 by Vachelagrave. Now, at this point, white has a couple or also three ways to continue. Karjakin chose knight in e5. Let's come back one move and let's see another line. Another idea was queen in g5, pinning the bishop and attacking the c 5 pawn. So Vashita Grav could have answered with bishop in b5, that also led the queen to protect this pawn. Rook in g3 is the very good continuation with the mate threat in one. F6, attacking the queen and letting the black queen to protect g7. But after queen in d5 we check, and rook in h8, because of course Vashita Grav couldn't play queen in f7, because after rook in e7, even capturing the queen, the game is over, because it's mate in 2. So after king in h8, knight in d6, threatening the check, of course, in f7. So in this position, white is clearly winning, because the bishop doesn't have good squares where to go. Also, the rook is forced to remain in f8 to protect from this check in f7. So this line was also very good. But after we said rook in f8, Karjakin chose knight in e5. Bishop moves in d5, attacking the a2 pawn. Now rook in g3 and the bishop is pinned. F6, good idea. Knight in d3. And this is the second topical moment in the game. Vashita Grav played bishop capture in a2, but this move will put the bishop out of the game, and white is clearly winning after this move, because after c4 the bishop will be out for some moves. Queen in d6 by Vashita Grav, knight in f4, queen in d4 we check, but unfortunately doesn't achieve nothing. King in h2, bishop recapture in c4, or capture in c4, tries to come back in the game. But queen in h6, another mate threat in one. F5 allow the queen to protect the bishop. But after knight in h5, attacking for the third time this point, Vashita Grav resigned, because there is no way to avoid the loss. In fact, let's make one example line. After rook in f7, that tries to defend for the third time the g7 square and the bishop, we have rook in e8, we check. Black rook is forced to come back. And after rook capture in g7, we check. If the queen doesn't capture and allow the mate like this, it's mate in the square. So we said that the last move of the game is this nice knight maneuver, knight in h5, that secures the match for Karjakin. So guys, also today's game is over. I hope you enjoyed this Karjakin game. It was a very nice attacking line. Please subscribe to the channel and like the video. And see you tomorrow for round 5. Thanks for watching and goodbye.